Hare Krishna. Those who underestimate their mind undermine their intelligence. Suppose there is a high security building that is being threatened by terrorists. Now, if the authorities in charge of the building have their intelligence agencies, their security agencies who are on guard, but if the authority figure becomes nonchalant, becomes casual, becomes complacent, thinking that the terrorists are not that dangerous, then what happens? Then they will undermine their intelligence, because the intelligence says, don't do this, don't meet people without proper security screening, don't allow people to come in like this. They will just neglect the intelligence warning, and the result of this will be that they will be destroyed. Terrorists will sneak in and they will destroy. So our consciousness is also like a high security building. Now, we may not very much value our consciousness in terms of maintaining its sanctity and purity and its focus, but the forces of illusion value our consciousness because they are waiting for whatever opportunity they might get to sneak in and to take over our consciousness. And that's why it is important for each one of us to do all that we can for focusing on protecting our consciousness. And that first thing is to not undermine the mind. The mind is the primary vortex through which the forces of illusion attack and sabotage us. And the mind is inside us. And the mind can be our enemy, as Krishna says repeatedly in the Bhagavad-Gītā. Krishna says, Bandhuratmātmanastasya yenātmaivātmanājitaha anātmanastu shatrutve vartetātmaiva shatruvat. In 6.6 he says that if the mind is uncontrolled, then it is our worst enemy. So we need to be first of all aware that our mind is dangerous. If we underestimate our mind, thinking that, this small laxity, small complacency, it won't make any difference. Well, it can make a huge difference. And that's why each one of us has to be cautious, has to be determined, has to be diligent. Those who undermine their mind, those who underestimate their mind, they undermine their intelligence. That means that if dangerous people are allowed to enter into a security building, then what can the security do? How can they guard? So when we allow ourselves to be exposed to dangerous temptations, then our intelligence becomes paralyzed. Our intelligence becomes disempowered. And then when the intelligence is disempowered, it cannot guard us. And then within moments, we may find that we are overpowered. The Bhagavad-Gita says that if we contemplate on sensual objects, the outer world or the inner mind may bring temptations for us to see. And once we see those temptations, then what happens? Once we dwell on them, dhyayato vishayan pumsaha sangasteshu pajayate sangat sanjayate kamaha kamat krodho vijayate krodhat bhavati sammoha sammohat smuti vibhrama smuti bhramashat buddhinasho buddhinashat pranashyati. So, buddhinashat pranashyati. If what the mind presents, if we contemplate, then our intelligence gets destroyed and eventually we succumb. So, knowing that our mind is dangerous, we needn't underestimate the mind, and we need to live in harmony with our intelligence, guided by Gita wisdom. Then we will be able to protect ourselves and we will be able to fulfill our spiritual potential. Thank you. Hare Krishna.